really explore the possibilities that lie behind laughter. And of course, most of us know the story about Norman Cousin and how he virtually healed himself laughing by watching Marx Brothers and a number of other shows. Mm-hmm. He checked himself out of the hospital because he thought the hospital isn't the place for a sick person.
Now, who is this? Norman Cousins?
Norman Cousins.
Yeah, he wrote the book Anatomy of an Illness.
You've heard him?
Oh, yes. I quote him often in my workshops and seminars.
Oh, do you? Okay.
Unfortunately, his book was successful on the bestseller list for 40 weeks at one time, but then it kind of, the flame quieted down, and now there's been a recurring interest in healing with laughter.
What was his book?
Anatomy of an Illness.
Anatomy of an Illness. And he laughed himself well.
Well, he had this condition called ankylosing spondylitis, which is a very difficult, painful inflammation of the spine. And there's no cure for it. There was no cure for it in the 60s. There's no cure for it today. And in the hospital, he was sitting there. And remember the days when there was only three or four channels, you know, ABC, CBS, NBC, and National Public Radio,
The good old days.
He noticed when he's, you know, in the hospital room then, there was nothing else except that TV hanging from the ceiling. And whenever Hogan's Heroes, a Candid Camera, or a Marx Brothers movies came on, he was like laughing hysterically for a good period. Uh-huh. And he noticed that he felt fantastic afterwards. And it lasted for almost 2 hours. A good hearty laugh for like 15, 20 minutes gave him almost 2 hours of pain-free existence. So first he thought he was imagining things. And then he said, you know, I'm not going to stay here and like suffer all day waiting for Candid Camera to come on. So he checked himself out of the hospital against medical advice, AMA, and went home. And he made it his business to purchase all the 8-track cassettes he could get his hands on of Marx Brothers, Candid Camera, all those shows. And he sat home and he just watched funny things, made himself laugh just to manage his pain, because his prognosis was like, you're going to die in 6 to 8 months or a year or whatever. And you know what? He didn't just cure. He went into remission and he cured himself. So it was beyond, he went way beyond pain management.
What an amazing story.
Now that was westernized in the Journal of the American Medical Association. He wrote a letter to the editor. But my trainer, my teacher, Dr. Madan Kataria, who taught me laughter meditation, laughter yoga, and laughter therapy for patient use, read that book and said, this is gold. We should be doing this all the time. And this is in Bombay, in Mumbai, India. So he went and developed these laughter groups on the beach for free for his patients. And in the beginning, they started just telling jokes and stuff. And he was like experimenting. But after a while, as Norman Cousins once wrote in his book, one man's ha-ha is another man's ho-hum. You cannot guarantee that the same, even if you're in the same religion, the same demographic, the same family, you're not going to laugh at the same jokes.
That's a good point.
Dr. Kataria said, we've got to find a way to make people laugh for no reason, just like the absurdity of life. And he developed this thing called laughter yoga. And so fast forward to 2004, I came to Cambridge for a training because I was a licensed clinical social worker. And I was looking for ways to manage stress for my patients. And at the hospital in New York, I worked full-time at Mount Sinai in New York. And I was running already depression support groups, diabetic support groups, stress management. And so what else can I give my patients? And also September 11th was in the mix. I was in the hospital work during that crazy time. And everybody was like this, including me. And I'm a long-term meditator, and I have a prayer life, and I was still like stressed. So I found laughter therapy. And long story short, it's a great training. And what happens when you do the training with Dr. Kataria, and anybody can take this, by the way. It's not just for professionals. He does programs for the lay people, everyone. You learn to do these positions, and it's positions that are so bizarre and so silly that you have to laugh. But it forces a person to break out of their comfort zone. People who come to my programs, and all my programs are listed on my website, you know, at mirthmaven.com, all those programs show people, first give them the cognitive piece, how important it is to laugh, and I can talk about the physical benefits of laughter, but the broad brush is, you learn to embrace the paradoxes and the absurdities of your life instead of being a victim. I'm giving you the real summary.